There's a thousand miles between you and I. Oh, my, my, my. Just a thousand miles between me and paradise.
To Hoover Dam today. We're gonna go check out Hoover Dam, see what it looks like from the air, and we're gonna fly over Lake Mead. Should be a great day for it. There's not a cloud in the sky. The winds are calm. I'm stoked. This is our plane. It's a 165 Papa Sierra. It's a Diamond Star DA-40 four-seat plane. It's a great plane. These are the planes that I used to teach people how to fly in Montana. Trained a lot of pilots on this plane. It's a great plane for training, but it's also just a great plane to go up and fly. So I first started flying my senior year of high school. My grandpa bought me an intro flight for my birthday. It was a 30-minute flight. And I went out and did that, and then I was hooked. So after that, I decided I wanted to get my private pilot's license. I got my private license, and then I just kept going with it from there. I got my instrument rating, later got my commercial rating, and then I became a flight instructor. And I did flight instructing for about 4.5 years up in Montana. So I got about 2,500 flight hours. I got most of my hours when I was instructing. And to kind of put that in perspective, to be a airline pilot, to apply for an airline job, you need to have about 1,500 hours. People always ask me, they say, what does it take to be a good pilot? And I think the main thing is you have to be a good multitasker. Another thing is you need to be teachable. A good pilot is always learning. And yeah, my favorite part about flying, it's just, for me, it's like therapy. You get up there in the sky. It's a lot of times, it's just me and the airplane. It's a big sense of responsibility, but it's also a sense of freedom. And so it's something I really enjoy. And yeah, whenever I have the opportunity, I try to go up and fly.
Beautiful day to fly. It's nice and smooth up here. Yeah, there's just something peaceful about being in the air. It's just a sense of freedom. And here's Lake Mead. The water levels are looking alarmingly low. Las Vegas is in a drought right now. And it's pretty scary how low the water levels are getting, but it's beautiful to see it from up here. And I'm gonna flip around here. We're gonna get a good shot of the Hoover Dam. We're going to try to fly over it and see what it looks like from the air.
Settle for the ghost. taken over 3 years to accomplish this.
Let's get down to business.
Over 50,000 tons of dirt, that's over 1,000 dump truck loads of dirt.
Million nights just like this. So let's get down to business. Let's get down to business. Give you one more night, gather.
Okay, here we are. Look at the land. It is completely flat. And it is completely paved. There's the road that goes out to the other exit.
It's been a while since I had your attention. So it might hurt to hit it. Let's get down to business. Give you one more night, got this. We've had
a land that's reclamated in the stream.
It's like a completely different piece of land.
Hey Jay, this is Oliver.
Hey Oliver, what's up?
Well, I have some news, some good news and some bad news.
Okay.
The good news, the tent made it through customs, but the bad news is I haven't heard from the truck driver in about 2 days.